Phocis Dakar served as the captain of the Second Fellowship of the Thousand Suns Legion during the Great Crusade and Horus Heresy. An exceptionally powerful psyker, Dakar would be a respected senior member of the 15th Legion. Magister of the Templi Raptora cult, Dakar would serve alongside the Lunar Wolves during the early campaigns of the Thousand Suns, exterminating the Kelikid species of Xenos. Forging bonds of friendship with the 16th Legion elite commanding officers Ezekiel Abaddon and Hasta Sejanus, Phocis Dakar would take pride in his involvement of the Ulanor Triumph against the hordes of greenskin armies alongside his Primarch, Magnus the Red. His incredible feats of psychic strength exemplified during his battle against the Xenos Titan, wherein he would project a gigantic telekinetic shield strong enough to protect his battle brothers from the War Machine's might, saving the life of his Primarch in the process. With the decree of the Council of Nicaea to ban the use of psychic powers within the Imperium, Dakar, like most of his legion, would remain isolated on his homeworld of Prospero. As a senior captain of his legion, he would discover and divulge the psychically gleaned portents of the betrayal of Horus Lupercal and relay the information to Magnus the Red. Despite his Primarch's apathy to their situation, Dakar would be the first to take up arms to face the walls of Fenris during the burning of Prospero, orchestrated by the Warmaster. Alongside Azek Araman, Phocis Dakar would lead his men in the resistance of their extermination by the hands of the Space Wolves, Sisters of Silence, and Adeptus Custodes. Felling several Custodes, Astartes, and Null Maidens using various tactics and adaptive strategies to circumvent his foes' strengths and strike at their weaknesses. Dakar would unleash his psychic potential, attempting to capitalize on a moment of weakness wherein Primarch Leman Russ lay vulnerable in battle. His path blocked by Custodian Constantine Valdor, Dakar knew it within his power to easily slay the champion of the Custodes with his psychic power. However, Dakar would rapidly succumb to his Legion's warp curse of the Flesh Change, transforming him into a monster. Surrendering to death at the hands of Valdor, rather than become a creature of chaos, Dakar would prove himself as one of the deadliest Astartes to ever stand in battle. Yet pride would see him relent his power, the cost too great in turning him into a tool of the ruinous powers.